Thank you. Please join me in the call to worship. There is room for you here. If you're weary and worn or hopeful and patient, if you're tired and lost or wrapped up in hope, if you're new to this place or have been here before, come in, come in. There is room for you here. The angels are singing, "Be not afraid." The angels are singing good news and great joy. Come in. There is room for us here. Let us worship God.
A weary world, hold on to hope, practice peace, spread joy, or know love. How does a weary world combat cruelty? How does a weary world shine a light into our bleakest night?
We do all these things with God's help. For tonight, a child is born in Bethlehem. Tonight, Christ draws near. Tonight, we light the Christ candle. Tonight, we are not alone. God is near. Love has drawn close. Rejoice.
Let us pray. Loving God, thank you that you draw near to us each and every day. Tonight we ask Holy Spirit to help us make room for you in our hearts, in our lives, and in how we love others. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
We gather to worship tonight as the people of Ravensworth Baptist Church, who on this night remember when God with us was born. We gather asking again, how does a weary world rejoice? Tonight we start by bringing our full selves and making room. And in this service, we begin with our favorite Christmas warning from Reverend Quinn Caldwell. If you came to this place expecting a tame story, you came to the wrong place. If you came for a story that does not threaten you, you came for a different story than the one we tell here. If you came to hear of the coming of a God who only showed up so that you could have a nice day with your loved ones, then you came for a God who we do not worship here. For even a regular baby is not a tame thing. And goodness that cannot threaten complacency and evil is not much good at all. And a God who would choose to give up power and invincibility to become an infant for you certainly didn't do it just so you could have dinner. But if you came because you think that unwed teenage mothers are some of the strongest people in the world, if you came because you think the people who work the third shift might attract an angel's attention before you, if you came because you think there are wise people to be found among undocumented travelers from far lands, that they might be able to show you God. If you came to hear a story of tyrants trembling while heaven comes to the Palestinian people. If you came because you believe that God loves the animals as much as the people, and so he made them the first witness to this story. If you came for a story of reversals that might end up reversing you. If you came for a tale of adventure and bravery where strong and gentle people win and the powerful and violent go down to dust, where the rich lose their money but find their lives and the poor are raised up. If you came to be reminded that God loves you too much to leave you unchanged. If you came to follow the light even if it blinds you. If you came for salvation and not safety, then, oh, my friends, you are in the right place tonight. Let us worship God.
This thing on? Hi. How are you? Do you think that the sanctuary looks a little different today? What did we do?
Changing the seats.
We changed the seats around, didn't we? This is a season of Advent, and something seems to be missing. What was up here? Did we have an Advent candle thingy up here? Where is it now? Do you see it anywhere? We moved it over in the corner because today is kind of a two-parter. This is the fourth day of Advent, and we've been waiting for 4 weeks. 4 weeks. But today is also Christmas Eve. So look up on the communion table. Do we have a light up there? That's the special candle. Now, what have we been waiting for? What have we been waiting for? Well, for Christmas, and with Christmas times comes Jesus being born. And I opened the post this morning and found the most beautiful picture. Look at this. They celebrate Jesus being born all over the world. It made the Washington Post, probably CNN. Now, I gave it away. What's your name?
Sadie.
You got any more to your name? What's your whole name?
Sadie Pearl Davis.
What's your name?
Lydia Ellen Davis.
Lydia Ellen Davis.
Harper Marjorie Shutter.
Harper Marjorie? What's your sister's name?
Maybell Lynn Schroeder.
My name is Nancy Elaine Saunders Kohler. And what's the name of the baby that's being born?
Jesus.
Jesus had some more names. Christ became a second name. And read this here.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince and Peace.
Prince of Peace. You know, the day you were born could have been day or night. I remember one time I said, I'm sure everybody was born in a hospital, and somebody raised their hand and said, no, I was born at home, so I'm not going to ask that question again. But when your parents were born, they had picture names out, probably, and they sort of passed you around after you were born when people came in and said, what's your name her? What's your name her? And there was lots of potential being thought of. They were trying to think of what you would be when you grew up. And some of these names were given to Jesus, and the angel Gabriel happened to name him Jesus. But long before he was born, they knew he was going to be special. And long before you were born, we knew you were going to be special. We just don't know what it's going to be yet. Now, can you hold this for me? Okay. You know, we've been putting their stuff on in the manger scene. Okay. And when people came to see you in the hospital when you were born, they were, oh, can I hold her? Can I hold her? Can you hold Jesus? What's his name?
Peter.
Jesus. Can you pass that to her and tell her what the name is? What's its name? What's his name? This is Jesus. This is our symbol of Jesus. Is this a symbol of Jesus? This is our representation. Would you give this to Dylan behind you? And Dylan's going to go and place it up there in the manger. And we'll almost have our complete set. Because there was so much potential. You may go ahead. There, thank you. Because there was so much potential, and we know by the post that everybody in the world knows this is happening. Everybody back in Jesus' time knew it was something special too. In a couple of weeks, we're going to add wise men to our manger scene. And they will have been waiting too, to come forth and recognize who this very special person was. I'm expecting each of you to be something very special also. And I can't wait to see what it's going to be. You got it? Thank you.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child.
I invite you to join me in singing our next hymn, hymn number 159, There's a Song in the Air. Let us sing all stanzas.
While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Y aconteció que estando ellos allí, se cumplieron los días de su alumbramiento, y dio a luz a su hijo primogénito, y lo envolvió en pañales, y lo acostó en un pesebre, porque no había lugar para ellos en el mesón.
And much of you join me in singing once more, this time number 147, Away in a Manger. Let us lift our voices in singing all stanzas. Thank you.
Holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt his worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Grateful chorus. sorrows raise we, let all our world us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord.
In the same region, there were some shepherds staying out in the fields and keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord suddenly stood near them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terribly frightened. So the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly army of angels, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among people with whom he is pleased."
You're invited to sing once more. This time we turn to hymn number 153. "It came upon a midnight clear." We'll remain seated as we sing all four stanzas.
Thank you. You're invited to rise in body or spirit to hear this reading of the gospel. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go down to Bethlehem and see this thing that's taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. This is the gospel of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
You're invited to remain standing as we share together our next hymn, number 155, Angels We Have Heard on High, number 155.
Thank you. how does a weary world rejoice? So, I'm in a few weeks from turning 40. For me, it is scary to turn 40 years old. I now find myself talking to people about how aging has changed my life. For example, during gatherings, I now talk to people about some medication that I'm taking. When someone responds back to me saying, hey, I'm also taking those pills, or perhaps someone says, hey, I'm taking that pill plus this other one, my immediate reaction is happiness. I should be sad to learn that someone is going through my same struggles. However, I'm happy to learn that someone is going through my same struggles. That is weird, right? Well, I think that the fact of knowing others understand my struggles gives me comfort. It gives me a sense of belonging, a sense of community, that I am not alone. Today, 2,000 years ago, God became human. He became human just like you and me. He went through all the same emotions you and I go through. For example, I imagine that he felt sadness when his dad, Joseph, passed away, fear of persecution by authorities, anger at corruption and injustice. Jesus felt all emotions we're familiar with and made us weary. The situation in Palestine 2,000 years ago is not much different from the one today. Jesus understands firsthand our feelings and our weariness. So, Ravensworth, how does a weary world rejoice? Praying. Today we were given the most amazing miracle of all. We were given the chance to pray to a God that understands our weariness because he felt our weariness. Ravensworth, rejoice in your church. RBC is a church of action. Rejoice in the fact that you're making this community, nation, and world a better place.
Thank you for words of encouragement, Jose. Let you join me in singing our next hymn, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, hymn number 150. We'll sing all stanzas.
Sing glory to the newborn King.
invite you to join me in reading responsibly our call to confession and prayer of confession. Loving Christ, Scripture tells us that you were born in a stable because there was no room in the inn. There was no room in the inn for a woman in need. No room in the inn for an innocent baby. Forgive us. We should have learned our lesson by now, but just as others turn their hearts to you, we continue to turn our backs on one another. Teach us how to make room for one another. Teach us how to make room. Carve out a space in our hearts to love as you love. For we do not want to build hostility here. We want to build your promised day.
As forward,
with hope and honesty we pray. Amen. As surely as we've gathered, as surely as we've prayed, as surely as we have sought God's forgiveness, we indeed are forgiven. Praise be to God. I invite you to join me in singing O Little Town of Bethlehem. You'll find a new text as part of your bulletin, part of your program tonight. I invite you to sing that text as we sing four stanzas of O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
We are singing our Christmas story tonight. Luke did the same thing. His Christmas story was framed by one of great hope through the songs that we've heard all during this season of Advent, singing of hope, especially in the midst of distress. This morning, Pastor Anna shared a quote from Reverend Michi Raheb, the founder of Bright Stars of Bethlehem, one of our RBC mission partners here. This is the rest of the quote. The Christmas story is also the story of angels who sang and proclaimed glory to God in the highest, glory to God and not the mighty empire. The peace that the angels proclaimed was not the peace of Rome, the peace of the empire, not based on the subjugation of other people. These angels sang of a different kind of peace built of human dignity, equality, and justice. The Christmas story is the story of Herod, the ruthless ruler, who in order to stay in power, ordered the deaths of children. Bethlehem gave Jesus to the world. It is high time for the world to give peace to Bethlehem and all of Palestine. Dr. Rulakuri Mansour, who is the founder and director of the Nazareth Center for Peace Studies, tells of a song that children sing every Christmas in Arabic called Laylat al-Milad, on Christmas night. She writes, the verses like a prophetic melody declare the transformative power of Christmas. It goes something like this. On Christmas night, hatred vanishes. On Christmas night, the earth blooms. On Christmas night, war is buried. On Christmas night, love is born. She continues, as we embrace the message of On Christmas Night, may it serve as a reminder that Christmas carries a universal call to action, one like this from Father Mansour Labaki. When we offer a glass of water to a thirsty person, we are in Christmas. When we clothe a naked person with a gown of love, we are in Christmas. When we wipe the tears from weeping eyes, we are in Christmas. When we cushion a hopeless heart with love, we are in Christmas. When the spirit of revenge dies in me, I am in Christmas. When hardness is gone from my heart, I am in Christmas. When my soul melts in the being of God, I am in Christmas. The song's verses reflect the transformative power of love, urging us to extend compassion and kindness, not just within ourselves, but to the war-torn lands yearning for peace. In the face of oppression, may our collective efforts be the light that guides us to a better future. And moments ago, we sang, O Little Town of Bethlehem, with different words, I'm sure you noticed, to reflect our present world. O Holy Child of Bethlehem, reveal to us thy way. Of justice, peace, and healing grace be born in us today. We are the Christmas angels. Help us glad tidings tell. O walk with us, shine forth through us, each one, Emmanuel. It is the singing, specifically the singing in community, which will help this weary world rejoice. It's choosing to be part of a community that sings ceasefire now and end the occupation and free the captives and love wins and Black Lives Matter and God's justice rolls down like waters, which will empower us to keep doing the work so we can really say, I am in Christmas. So whether we sing Mary's song, O Holy Night, O Little Town of Bethlehem, Laylat al-Milad, or Silent Night, as we will in just a few moments, may we earnestly promise to be the Christmas angels that are working to bring peace on earth. For on Christmas night, hatred vanishes. On Christmas night, the earth blooms. On Christmas night, war is buried. On Christmas night, love is born. May it be so. Amen.
Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, didn't know who you were, didn't know you came to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes were blind, we couldn't see. We didn't know who you were. Long time ago, you were born in a manger low, sweet little Jesus boy. The world treats you mean, Lord, treats me mean too. But please, sir, forgive us, Lord. Didn't know it was you. Sweet little Jesus boy, born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, and we didn't know who you were.
Let us pray together. Holy God, we have been waiting a long time for this night, for the joy and the quiet of Christmas Eve, for the sound of the angel chorus, for the old familiar songs. We have carried weary hearts through the last 4 weeks of Advent, longing for the peace and hope of this night, and now we are finally here. Yet we know there is not peace and hope everywhere in this world. In fact, there is no peace in the very place where the Christ child was born. Remind us that you are Emmanuel, God with us. So God, between our joy and our weariness, we ask that you would make room. Pour yourself into the cracks of our hearts. Carve out space for your love in the center of our being, so that no matter where we go, we might trust the angels when they say, "Be not afraid," and joy to the world. May we be the ones who sing songs of hope and peace and joy and love. Amen.
Just a moment, the ushers will be coming forward to be sharing the light with us all. I've been asked to kindly remind everyone the safest way to share the light. If someone has the light and you're getting it from them, you will put your candle to the light sideways. If you have the light, you are asked to hold it steady, upright, so it doesn't drip wax on you and anyone else around you. Let us sing together, Silent Night. We invite you to rise in body or spirit as we sing.
Silent night, O Lord.
Our ushers will be at the door to collect candles and also donations to our benevolence fund as you leave. This fund serves those in need in our congregation and our community, and we ask that you give generously tonight. So tonight, go forth practicing hope. There are stars in the sky telling stories of salvation. Go to look for the one who shows us how to live. We go in peace tonight. Amen.